Today, on social media, you have plenty of those people that fall into innovation out of ignorance. And they don't want to be criticized. And they don't want to be mentioned. And they don't want to be corrected. And they want to issue fatwa left and right. And they want to type on their keyboards and give lectures on every subject matter, whether they know it or they, and most of them don't even know Arabic. They don't even know the basic of Arabic. They don't even know anything. But they want to point fingers at others who don't know because they're teaching the يعني يا جماعة الخير الله المستعان الله المستعان. If you only comprehend this, wallahi, you'll be in peace. You'll be in Jannah of the dunya before you go to the Jannah of the Akhirah بإذن الله عز وجل. Wallahi, you'll be in the Jannah of the dunya from a belief point of view. You know exactly what to believe about Allah. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, ni'mah. Wallahi, it's a bounty after which there's no bounty. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Wassalatu wassalamu al-atamman al-akmalani ala khayri khalqillahi ajma'in. نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala abundantly the way He deserves to be praised. And we ask Allah to exalt the mention and grant peace and send His blessings and salutations upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yes, yes, yes. Al-Aqeedatul-Waasitiyyah li-Shaykh-ul-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah bi-sharh الشيخ محمد بن صالح بن عثيمين عليهم رحمة الله. We have been discussing some really exciting topics pertaining to the Aqeedah of Ahl-us-Sunnah wal-Jamaa'ah. And we've already established that we believe in what Allah described Himself with. And we believe in what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described Allah with in his Sunnah. And we mentioned that there are multiple methods via which we confirm that. It could be an action, it could be a verbal statement, or it could be an acknowledgement or an approval of some sort. Then we went on to say that while we believe in those, there are some things that we don't do in the process. Meaning we have affirmation and negation. And one of the negations is that we, Ahl-us-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah, don't do any tahrif. And we said tahrif is a form of distortion. We covered that topic in the last class. Today, brothers and sisters, we are going to discuss a critical subject matter that we also, as Ahl-us-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah, don't get involved in, and it's called At-Ta'atil. The Shaykh said, وَلَا تَعْطِيل. At-Ta'atil بمعنى التخلية والترك. Ta'atil is to forsake something and to abandon it. كَقَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى وَبِئْرٍ مُعَطَّلَةٍ. Allah Azza wa Jal says, and a deserted well. مُعَطَّلَة meaning it's left alone, it's neglected, it's abandoned. أي مُخْلَى وَمَتْرُوكَ. مُخْلَاةٌ مَتْرُوكَ. It is left and abandoned. وَالْمُرَادُ بِالتَّعْطِيلِ إِنْكَارُ مَا أَثْبَتَ. Of course, that was the linguistic meaning. The legislative meaning, contextually speaking, in theological discussions, إِنْكَارُ مَا أَثْبَتَ اللَّهُ لِنَفْسِهِ مِنَ الْأَسْمَاءِ وَالصِّفَاتِ. It is a form of denying or rejecting what Allah described Himself with from in terms of His names and attributes. سَوَاءً كَانَ كُلِّيًّا أَوْ جُزْئِيًّا. Regardless of whether it is wholly or partly. Oh, Bismillah. And in the context of holy, I want to make a couple of comments and remarks. Holy here is obviously spelled W-H-O-L-L-Y from whole. There's another holy, which is that which is sacred, or something that has a sanctity of some sort, or it could be of divine nature. And I've had this very interesting back and forth. You know, Facebook is a place where every keyboard warrior resides. All of these people who usually lack respect for the most part, they have these hatred that has been hidden and concealed in them for years, and it comes out. It comes out. Anytime you preach Salafiyya, you're hated. Just like when the Prophet ﷺ used to preach Tawheed, He was hated by the disbelievers of Quraysh. Today you preach Salafiyya, People try to pick on things that you say and claim that they have issues with those, but in reality, they have greater issues with the methodology that you invite to. And that's understandable. That's understandable because when you're deviant or when you prefer something other than the way of the Sahaba, even though you claim to be following the Sahaba, of course you're going to have issues. So these people had all these problems with me saying that you cannot use the term Holy Quran. And they were going at it and trying to give me definitions from the dictionary. And I'm just going to explain for you to understand as well. Why do we not say Holy Quran? I tried to explain to these brothers, may Allah bless them and reward them with goodness, that the term holy, if it's used as an adjective, it's absolutely sound. If someone asked me, is the Quran holy? I would say, by all means, it's holy because the Quran is an attribute of Allah. It's the speech of Allah. It's Kalamullah. So fundamentally speaking, it is definitely holy. And as an adjective to describe the Quran, I will use this anytime. The point of contention that these brothers don't seem to understand is that you don't want to have a title that wherein we call the Quran as a proper noun, the Holy Quran, and then we standardize it just like the Christians had their Holy Bible. And my answer, which they don't get, is that, ya akhi, if Allah Azza wa Jal wanted to use that term, that adjective, to become a proper noun, potentially, Allah would have used it in the Quran at least once, Al-Quran Al-Muqaddas. Or the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam would have called the Quran Al-Quran Al-Muqaddas. But we have Allah saying Qur'anun Azeem, Qur'anun Majid, Qur'anun Kareem. Allah used different noble Qur'an, glorious Qur'an, the great Qur'an, but Allah never used Qur'anun Muqaddas. Therefore, for us to now come and coin this term and use it consistently, just like the Christians have their Holy Bible, is something that we Muslims don't need to do. If you don't agree, ya akhi, no problem. No problem, but to prove to you that it is not about those minor opinions that you discount for. And by the way, this statement of mine has backup. You think I come up with these on my own? They are fatawa from websites that you don't take seriously because we differ, ya akhwan, on methodology. We differ on methodology. You waver with the environment and we try to stick to the truth in spite of our shortcomings. We say we have shortcomings. I'm unable to live up to the truth, but that's my own shortcoming. That's the difference between us. You just want to play around. We're not here to play around. Brothers, you know, Aib, your brother. Yeah, brother, whatever your name is. You come to my porch, then I will, you know, knock you out. Ya akhi, what is this, a child, ya akhi? If you're not married, get married so you can relieve this frustration. And if you're married, ya akhi, use this energy on raising your children. And let your children read these comments, ya akhi. We think, yani, I go to the gym also, and I'm with you. I'm here to fist fight with you. This is, yani, foolish. Suhaib Web mentality. You bring it on, and then you have a problem with Salafi. Ya akhi, wallah, the problem is with you, ya akhi. Wallahi, you have the problem. The term Holy Quran, it's a sound opinion. You don't have to agree with it. The same thing with wedding rings and engagement rings. All of these have, this is the statement of Shaykh al-Albani. You call it an utterly retarded fatwa. Then you're calling that of Shaykh al-Albani, that this is the description you're giving him. You will meet Allah with those statements on the last day. But you need to calm down, man. Yani, guys, yani, wallah, aib. Aib, yani, the type of, wallah, I don't know what to tell you. Ala kulli hal, may Allah forgive us and forgive you and guide you. So, just so you can understand, people have a fundamental issue with what we call to, and we understand it's very difficult for them to swallow, but maybe if Allah expands their chest, then they will be better recipients to this information. طيب. إذن we said سواء كان كليا أو جزئيا وسواء كان ذلك بتحريف أو بجحود هذا كله اسمه تعطيلا. And whether they distort or they reject completely, all of this is called تعطيل or a form of denial. فأهل السنة والجماعة لا يعطلون أي اسم من أسماء الله. The people of Sunnah wal Jama'ah, Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they do not deny any name from the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أو أي صفة من صفات الله. Nor do they deny any attribute from the attributes of Allah. ولا يجحدونها. And they do not abandon it altogether. They do not abandon it altogether. بل يقرون بها إقرارا كاملا. Rather, they have complete approval. They approve it completely. فَإِنْ قُلْتَ مَا الْفَرْقُ بَيْنَ التَّعْطِيلِ وَالتَّحْرِيفِ. If you ask a question, what is the difference then between ta'til, denial, and tahrif, distortion, because we mentioned that earlier. قُلْنَا التَّحْرِيفُ فِي الدَّلِيلِ وَالتَّعْطِيلُ فِي الْمَدْلُولِ. We use the term tahrif, distortion, in regards to the evidence itself. وَالتَّعْطِيلُ فِي الْمَدْلُولِ, and the denial is in regards to what the evidence refers to. In regards to what the evidence refers to, the end result of the evidence. What is the outcome of the evidence? Then they come and do a denial of that. As for the text itself, they do distortion of that. فَمَثَلًا إِنْ قَالَ قَائِلٌ إِذَا قَالَ قَائِلٌ مَعْنَى قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى بَلْ يَدَاهُ مَبْسُوطَتَانْ. If a person were to say, بَلْ يَدَاهُ مَبْسُوطَتَانْ, nay, both his hands are extended or stretched out. أي بَلْ قُوَّتَهْ. If a person were to say, that means that it's his Allah's powers, Allah's strengths and powers. هذا محرف للدليل. This person now is distorting the evidence itself. ومعطل للمراد الصحيح, and he is denying the intended meaning, the intended correct meaning. لأن المراد اليد الحقيقية. What is intended is a true hand. What is intended by the ayah is the true hand in the ultimate sense. ولا اليد المحرف إليها اللفظ, and not the hand that they distorted the meaning. That they have distorted in the meaning, which is for them to mean قوة. نقول هذا مع أيوة نعم وأثبت نعم لأن المراد اليد الحقيقية فقد عطل المعنى الورد. What is intended is the true hand. So this person has denied the intended meaning وأثبت معنى غير المراد, and he affirmed any meaning other than the one intended. وإذا قال بل يداه مبسوطتان لا أدري. Now we're going to come into another technical issue. If a person were to say, nay, but both of his hands are stretched out, لا أدري, I don't know. أفوض الأمر إلى الله, I surrender the matter to Allah. لا أثبت اليد الحقيقية, I don't confirm a hand in reality. ولا اليد المحرف إليها اللفظ, nor do I give the meaning of the hand that the distorted meaning refers to, which is the power. نقول هذا معطل وليس بمحرف. We say this person is actually a denier and he's not a distorter. لأنه لم يغير معنى اللفظ, because he did not change the meaning of the text. ولم يفسره بغير مراده, nor did he give it a false interpretation. لكن عطل معناه الذي يراد به, but he still denied the intended meaning that came from those words. وهو إثبات اليد لله عز وجل, and that is in this context to affirm the hand for Allah the Mighty and Sublime. Ahl-us-Sunnah wal-Jamaa'ah yatabarra'una min at-tariqatayn. Ahl-us-Sunnah wal-Jamaa'ah, they declare their innocence from both paths. At-tariqa al-ula, the first path, hiya allati hiya tahrifu al-lafz bita'til ma'naha al-haqiqi al-murad ila ma'na ghayra murad. The first type is when you distort the text by denying the real intended meaning and you refer to a meaning other than the one intended. وَالطَّرِيقَةُ الثَّانِيَةُ, and the second path, وَهِيَ طَرِيقَةُ أَهْلُ التَّفْوِيدِ, it is the way of the people of surrendering the matter. تَفْوِيد is those who say, I don't know, I don't know, don't talk to me about it. فَهُمْ لَا يُفَوِّدُونَ الْمَعْنَى كَمَا يَقُولُهُ الْمُفَوِّضَةُ, they don't really يعني leave the meaning abandoned like those مفوضة really do. بل يقولون نحن نقول بل يداه أي يداه الحقيقتان مبسوطتان وهما غير القوة والنعمة. They will say that rather the two hands are intended other than the power and the bounty, which is one of the interpretations of the people of deviation, is that they give it a different meaning than the one Allah عز وجل has intended. So they are neither might nor favor. نعم. فعقيدة أهل السنة والجماعة بريئة من التحريف ومن التعطيل. The عقيدة, the methodology, the creed of the people of the Sunnah and the Jama'ah is declaring their innocence from distortion and from denial. وبهذا نعرف ضلالة أو كذب من قالوا إن طريقة السلف هي التفويض. This is how we know that those who claim that the methodology of the Salaf is to say we leave the matters unknown. Huh? We surrender the matters in this manner are liars and misguided. هَؤُلَاءِ ضَلُّوا إِنْ قَالُوا ذَلِكَ عَنْ جَهْلٍ بِطَرِيقَةِ السَّلَفِ. They are misguided if they said so out of ignorance about the way of the Salaf. وَكَذَبُوا إِنْ قَالُوا ذَلِكَ عَنْ عَمْدٍ. And they have lied if they're purposely saying that. أَوْ نَقُولْ كَذَبُوا عَلَى الْوَجْهَيْنِ. Rather, we say they have lied either way. عَلَى لُغَةِ الْحِجَازِ. According to the language of the people of Hijaz. لِأَنَّ الْكَذِبَ عِنْدَ الْحِجَازِيِّينَ بِمَعْنَى الْخَطَأِ. Because the people here, when they say كَذِب, means mistake. The term lying is used to describe a lie and also a mistake. طيب. وَعَلَى كُلِّ حَالٍ لَا شَكَّ أَنَّ الَّذِينَ يَقُولُونَ إِنَّ مَذْهَبَ أَهْلَ السُّنَّةِ هُوَ التَّفْوِيدِ أَنَّهُمْ أَخْطَأُوا. And at any rate, there's no doubt that those who say that the way of the people of Sunnah is to surrender the matters. Again, let me explain to you. What does surrender the matter meaning? I say, Akhi, I don't know. I don't know if Allah has hands or not. I don't know if Allah has a face or not. I don't know if Allah rolls over the throne or not. I don't know. I'm not going to affirm. I'm not going to deny. I'm going to play it safe and just go have a picnic and put out the table spread and eat a sandwich and drink a tea. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Ya Allah, I am neither from the Athari people nor I am from the Ash'ari people. I have a peace of mind. I don't delve into these matters. I don't discuss them. Hooray! No, ya Hajj. No, ya Baba. It doesn't work. The people of Tafweed, as we will see, are among the worst people out there. So you cannot have this methodology of, okay, this is confusing, I'll leave it alone. This is your Lord. It cannot be confusing. Allah Azza wa Jal did not reveal the Quran with confusion. If you don't want to study, that's your issue. Otherwise, the matter is clear. Hey, لِأَنَّ مَذْهَبَ أَهْلِ السُّنَّةِ هُوَ إِثْبَاتُ الْمَعْنَى وَتَفْوِيدِ الْكَيْفِيَّةِ. The methodology, the madhab, the way of Ahl-us-Sunnah is to affirm the meaning. But we only say we surrender the how. The area where you can say, I don't know, is how. When someone says, how does Allah rise over the throne? How does Allah descend into the lowest heaven every day, every night, at the last third of the night? This we say, whoa, brother, I receive no revelation concerning that. The Prophet ﷺ did not discuss that. I keep my mouth zipped. That said, I will not go with the extreme and deny that those things happen because I have textual evidence that says that they happen. Do you understand how beautiful it is to be on the way of Ahl-us-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah? You're right in the middle. You don't go to either extreme. وَلْيُعْلَمْ أَنَّ الْقَوْلَ بِالتَّفْوِيدِ كَمَا قَالَ شَيْخُ الْإِسْلَامِ ابْنِ تَيْمِيَةِ مِنْ شَرِّ أَقْوَالِ أَهْلِ الْبِدْعِ وَالْإِلْحَادِ. Allahu Akbar. Wallah, be careful. It should be known that the people of Tafweed, as Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah said, are among the worst positions of the people of innovation and heresy. عندما يسمع الإنسان التفويض يقول هذا جيد. When you hear about Tafweed, meaning I surrender the matter to Allah, I don't know, you say, this is good. أسلم من هؤلاء وهؤلاء. I'm safe from either extreme. Those people and those people. لا أقول بمذهب السلف. I don't say about what the Salaf say in terms of affirming. ولا أقول بمذهب أهل التأويل. Nor am I approving with the people of interpretation, meaning those who distort the meaning. أسلك سبيلا وسطا. I will take a middle path between all of those extremes. وأسلم من هذا كله. And I will be safe from all of this. وأقول الله أعلم. I will say Allah knows best. ولا ندري ما معناها. We don't know what it means. لكن يقول شيخ الإسلام. But شيخ الإسلام says هذا من شر أقوال أهل البدع والإلحاد. This is among the worst statements of the people of innovation and heresy. سبحان الله وصدق رحمه الله. And he has said the truth. May Allah have mercy on him. إذا تأملته. If you reflect and ponder. وجدته تكذيبا للقرآن. You will find that it is a form of belying the Quran. وتجهيلا للرسول صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم. And it is a form of attributing ignorance to the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. واستطالة للفلاسفة. And giving the philosophers an edge over you. تكذيب للقرآن. Why do we say this is a form of belying the Quran and denying the Quran? لأن الله يقول, because Allah says, وَنَزَّلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ تِبْيَانًا لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ. And we have sent down to you the book as an exposition of everything. وأي بيان في كلمات لا يدرى ما لا يدرى ما معناها. What exposition is there in words in which the meaning you don't know, the meaning of which you don't know? If Allah said the Quran is an exposition, it exposes, it explains, it clarifies everything, how can the Quran, which has this quality, bring about meanings which you say, wallahi ya akhi, I don't know what it means. I am going to go to sleep right now. Wake me up when you know what it means. La ya baba. You have to know what it means, because the Quran says that the Quran will give you this type of clarification. وَهِيَّ مِنْ أَكْثِرِ مَا يَرِدُ فِي الْقُرْآنِ. And it comes so frequently and abundantly in the Quran. وَأَكْثَرَ مَا وَرَدَ فِي الْقُرْآنِ أَسْمَاءِ اللَّهِ وَصِفَاتِهِ. And among the things that are mentioned the most in the Quran are the names of Allah and His attributes. إِذَا كُنَّا لَا نَدْرِي مَا مَعْنَاهَا. If we don't know what it means, هَلْ يَكُونُ الْقُرْآنِ تِبْيَانًا لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ أَيْنَ الْبَيَانِ. If we don't know what it means, can we then say that the Quran is a form of clarification for everything? Then where is that exposition and where is that clarification? إِنَّ هَؤُلَاءِ يَقُولُونَ إِنَّ الرَّسُولَ لَا يَدْرِي إِلَّا الرَّسُولَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ لَا يَدْرِي عَنْ مَعَانِي الْقُرْآنِ فِيمَا يَتَعَلَّقُ بِالْأَسْمَاءِ وَالصِّفَاتِ. Furthermore, they're technically saying that the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم does not know the meaning of the Quran in regards to the names and attributes of Allah. وَإِذَا كَانَ الرَّسُولُ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ لَا يَدْرِي فَغَيْرُهُمْ بَابَ أَوْلَى. If the Prophet ﷺ himself does not know, then anyone else is more likely not to know. They couldn't, it's more obvious that they would not know. وَأَعْجَبُ مِنْ ذَلِكَ يَقُولُونَ الرَّسُولُ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ يَتَكَلَّمْ بِالْكَلَامِ فِي صِفَاتِ اللَّهِ. And what's even more amazing is that they say that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam will speak certain words in regards to the attributes of Allah, وَلَا يَدْرِي مَا مَعْنَاهَا, while he himself does not know what it means. يَقُول رَبَّنَ اللَّهُ الَّذِي فِي السَّمَاءِ. The Prophet ﷺ says, our Lord Allah who is above the heavens. وَإِذَا سُئِلَ عَنْ هَذَا قَالَ لَا أَدْرِي. But if you ask the Prophet ﷺ about that, he will say, I don't know. وَكَذَلِكَ فِي قَوْلِهِ يَنْزِلُ رَبُّنَا إِلَى سَمَاءِ الدُّنْيَا. When the Prophet ﷺ said, Allah, our Lord descends to the lowest heaven, the heaven of the dunya, meaning the lowest level of the seven heavens. وَإِذَا سُئِلَ مَا مَعْنَى يَنْزِلُ رَبُّنَا. And if he was asked, O Messenger of Allah, what does it mean that our Lord descends? قَالَ لَا أَدْرِي. He will say, I don't know. وَعَلَى هَذَا فَقِسْ. And then you could now measure accordingly. This is your yardstick. This is what they're saying. Because if they say the Prophet ﷺ was using these words and he doesn't know what they mean, because they're saying that we don't know either, we say the matter is to Allah, that you're suggesting that the Prophet ﷺ also didn't know. عَجِيبٌ أَمْرُكُمْ أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ. وَهَلْ هُنَالِكَ قَطْحٌ أَعْظَمٌ مِّنْ هَذَا الْقَطْحِ بِالرَّسُولِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. Is there any type of belittlement and defamation greater than this defamation to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? بل هذا من أكبر القدح. Rather, this is among the greatest forms of defamation. رسول من عند الله ليبين للناس. He's a messenger from Allah to clarify to the people. وهو لا يدري ما معنى آيات الصفات وأحاديثها. While he himself does not know the meaning of the ayat that speak about the attributes of Allah and the narrations that are relevant to that. وهو يتكلم بالكلام ولا يدري معنى ذلك كله. And he is speaking all this while he himself does not know the meaning of any of that. يعني, what is that, ya jama'a? What is that, ya jama'a? فَهَذَانِ وَجَنْ. So these are two different routes. تَكْذِيبُ الْقُرْآنِ. You're belying the Qur'an. وَتَجْهِيلُ الرَّسُولِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. And you're ascribing ignorance to the Prophet Muhammad صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. وَفِيهِ فَتْحُ الْبَابِ لِلزَّنَادِقَةِ الَّذِينَ تَطَاوَلُوا عَلَى أَهْلِ التَّفْوِيدِ. Furthermore, you are opening the door for the heretics that have gone to extreme in attacking the people of Tafweed. وَقَالُوا أَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْرِفُونَ شَيْئًا. So that now the zanadiqa, the heretical people are saying to the people of Tafweed, you guys don't know anything. بل نحن الذين نعرف الذين نعرف. We know, you don't know anything, we are the ones who know. وأخذوا يفسرون القرآن بغير ما أراد الله. And then they started to explain the Quran in a meaning other than what Allah عز وجل intended. وقالوا كوننا نثبت معاني للنصوص خَيْرٌ مِّن كَوْنِنَا أُمِّيِّنَا لَا نَعْرِفُ شَيْئًا. And he said to them, the fact that we are affirming some meaning for the text is better than us being illiterate and not knowing anything. وَذَهَبُوا يَتَكَلَّمُونَ بِمَا يُرِيدُونَ مِن مَعْنَى كَلَامِ اللَّهِ وَصِفَاتِهِ. And they went on to discuss whatever they wanted to in regards to the meaning of the speech of Allah and Allah's attributes. وَلَا يَسْتَطِيعُ أَهْلُ التَّفْوِيدِ أَنْ يَرُدُّ عَلَيْهِمْ. And the people of Tafweed are unable to retaliate and refute them. لِأَنَّهُمْ يَقُولُونَ نَحْنُ لَا نَعْلَمْ مَاذَا أَرَادَ اللَّهِ. Because they are forced to say, we don't know what Allah Azza wa Jal intended. فَجَائِزٌ أَنْ يَكُونَ الَّذِي يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ هُوَ مَا قُلْتُمْ. It is possible that whatever Allah, that Allah wills what you said. It is possible that that is the intent behind Allah's speech. فَفَتَحُوا بَابَ شُرُورٍ عَظِيمًا. They opened the door for tremendous amount of evil. وَلِهَذَا جَاءَتِ الْعِبَارَ الْكَاذِبَةِ. That's why they came up with this false statement. طَرِيقَةُ السَّلَفِ أَسْلَمْ وَطَرِيقَةُ الْخَلَفِ أَعْلَمُ أَحْكَمْ. So they came up with this nonsensical statement that says that the way of the Salaf is safer, but the way of those who came, the later generations, is more knowledge-based and wiser. That reminds me of some people today. That those back then, they were confused, and now, mashallah, tabarakallah, 1400 years later, 1500 years later, we've reached new realms and new intellectual domains that people in the past could not have ever reached, and therefore we know better than they do, and we have a better understanding of Islam than they did, and that is against the explicit Quran and the Sunnah, because Allah is pleased with them, and we have no guarantee that Allah is pleased with them. And because the Prophet ﷺ said, خَيْرٌ النَّاسِ قَرْنِي, the best of people is my generation than those who follow them and those who follow them. يقول شيخ الإسلام رحمه الله هذه قالها بعض الأغبياء. الله عليك يا شيخ الإسلام رحمة الله عليك. شيخ الإسلام said, this statement was said by some ignoramuses or some idiots actually. وهو صحيح أن القائل غبي. The Shaykh said, it is true, the one who made this statement is an idiot. هذه الكلمة من أكذب ما يكون نطقا ومدلولا. This statement is the falsest you can ever say in terms of utterance and the intent behind it. طريقة السلف أسلم. The way of the Salaf is safe. وطريقة الخلف أعلم أحكم. The later generations is wiser and better, more knowledge. كيف تكون أعلم أحكم وتلك أسلم. How can it be more knowledge-based and wiser, while the other one is safer? لا يوجد سلامة بدون علم وحكمة أبدا. You can never be safe if you don't have knowledge and wisdom to begin with. فالذي لا يدري عن الطريق, the one who doesn't know the path, لا يسلم, he can never be safe. لأنه ليس معه علم, he doesn't have knowledge. لو كان معه علم وحكمة, لو كان معه علم وحكمة, if he had knowledge and wisdom, لسلم, he would have been safe. فَلَا سَلَامَةَ إِلَّا بِعِلْمٍ وَحِكْمَةٍ. So you can never truly be safe until you have knowledge and wisdom. وَإِذَا قُلْتَ إِنَّ طَرِيقَةَ السَّلَفْ أَسْلَمْ لَزِمْ أَنْ تَقُولْ هِيَ أَعْلَمُ وَأَحْكَمْ. Because if you say that the way of the Salaf is safer, then you are obliged to also say, therefore, that it is also more knowledge-based and wiser. وَإِلَّا لَكُنْتَ مُتَنَاقِضًا. Otherwise, you are contradicting yourself. إِذَنْ فَالْعِبَارَةُ الصَّحِيحَةُ طَرِيقَةُ السَّلَفِ أَسْلَمْ وَأَعْلَمُ أَحْكَمْ. So the correct statement is, the way of the Salaf is safer and more knowledge-based and wiser. وَهَذَا مَعْلُومٌ. And this is something that is well-known. وَتَرِيقَةُ الْخَلَفِ مَا قَالَهُ الْقَائِلِ. As for the way of the later generations, it is what a poet once said. لَعَمْرِي لَقَدْ طُفْتُ الْمَعَاهِدَ كُلَّهَا وَسَيَرْتُ طَرْفَيْ بَيْنَ تِلْكَ الْمَعَالِمَ. Upon my life, I have toured all the places and walked myself in all these abodes. فَلَمْ أَرَى إِلَّا وَاضِعًا كَفَّ حَائِرٍ عَلَى ذَقَنٍ أَوْ قَارِعًا سِنَّ نادمي. I never saw except him who places hand confused upon his chin, upon his chin, or him who was gnashing the teeth in regret. Someone is just biting his teeth in regret. هذه الطريقة التي يقول عنها إنه ما وجد إلا واضعا كف حائر على ذقن. So he's saying that he only found people that follow this way to be, you know, sitting there just confused. وهذا ليس عنده علم. And this person does not have knowledge. أو آخر قارعا سن عفوا قارعا سن نادمي, or the other one who was in the state of regret لأنه لم يسلك طريق السلامة أبدا, because he never ever traveled upon the path of safety to begin with. والرازي, and الرازي وهو من كبرائهم, he's among the seniors and the people of the kalam and so on and so forth. He said, نهاية إقدام العقول عقال وأكثر سعي العالمين ضلال وأرواحنا في وحشة من جسومنا وغاية دنيانا أذى ووبال ولم نستفد من بحثنا طول عمرنا سوى أن جمعنا فيه قيل وقالوا. The end of the prowess of intellects is shackles, and most of the realms hasten to misguidance. Our souls are in loneliness from our bodies. The end of our life is danger and trial. We never benefited from our research all our life, except that we gathered in it, he said and they said. So he basically broke it down for you that all of this ilm al-kalam and all this falsafa, all this philosophical argumentation and giving precedence to your intellect, you waste your years and your life and you remain in a perpetual state of confusion and misguidance. Whereas the person who follows the path, no matter how young he is, no matter how, even if he's not as academic, no matter what his circumstance, what country he lives in, if he follows the path of the Salaf, he always has a peace of mind, he's in a state of safety, he's enjoying himself, he knows his Lord, he's worshipping his Lord, and he's ready to meet his Lord. It's beautiful, ya jama'a. ثم يقول لقد تأملت الطرق الكلامية والمناهج الفلسفية فما رأيتها تشفي عليلا ولا تروي غليلا ووجدت أقرب الطرق طريق القرآن طريقة القرآن. He said, I have reflected on the many different philosophical the statements of and the people of philosophy and their methods. I did not find them curing any ailment, nor did it satisfy and quench any thirst. And I found the soundest path to be the path of the Quran. أقرأ في الإثبات, I read what in the ayat that refers to affirmation. الرحمن على العرش استوى, the most merciful grows over his throne. The most merciful rose over his throne. إليه يصعد الكلم الطيب, to him ascends the goodly word. وأقرأ في النفي, and I recite in regards to negation. ليس كمثله شيء, there's nothing like unto him. وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِهِ عِلْمًا, and they do not encompass him in knowledge, in anything of knowledge. وَمَنْ جَرَّبَ مِثْلَ تَجْرُبَتِي عَرِفَ مِثْلَ مَعْرِفَتِي, whoever tries what I have tried will know what I have come to know. This is what Al-Razi said. This is what Al-Imam Al-Razi, who spent his years in this, the methodology of the people of philosophy and the philosophers and so on and so forth, and all these things were his field. At the end, he said, look man, it didn't cut it for me. It didn't satisfy. And I have to find it. The soundest way is the way of the Book of Allah. جَلَّ جَلَالُهُ وَتَقَدَّسَتْ أَسْمَاؤُهُ أَهَؤُلَاءِ نَقُولْ إِنَّ طَرِيقَتُهُمْ أَعْلَمْ وَأَحْكَمْ. Do we say about people like this that their way is more knowledge-based and wiser? الذي يقول إني أتمنى أن أموت على عقيدة عجائز نيسابور, the one who said that I wish to die upon the عقيدة of the old people of نيسابور, والعجائز من عوام الناس يتمنى أنه يعود إلى الأميات, and the older people among the laymen they wish to come back to life. هل يقال إنه أعلم أحكم. Do we say about a person like this that he has more knowledge and that he is wiser? Where is the knowledge that they possess? Where is it? فَتَبَيَّنَ أَنَّ طَرِيقَةَ التَّفْوِيدِ طَرِيقٌ خَاطِئٌ. So we have understood from this that the way of tafweed is a wrong way. لأنه يتضمن ثلاثة مفاسد, because it contains three different corruptions and three disadvantages, three evils. تكذيب القرآن, بلعن القرآن, وتجهيل الرسول عليه الصلاة والسلام, and attributing ignorance to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, واستطالة الفلاسفة, and giving an edge for the philosophers. وأن الذين قالوا إن طريقة السلف هي التفويل, and تفويل, anyone who claims that the way of the Salaf is the way of تفويل, كذبوا على السلف, they have lied against the Salaf. بل هم يثبتون اللفظ والمعنى, rather the people of the Salaf, they affirm the word, the text, and the meaning behind the text. ويقررونه, and they acknowledge it. ويشرحونه بأوفى شرح, and they explain it explicitly. They keep it, they affirm it, and they explain it to the people in the most, in the best type of explanation. They have nothing to be scared of, nothing to avoid, nothing to worry about. أهل السنة والجماعة لا يحرفون ولا يعطلون. So the people of Sunnah and Jama'ah, they do not distort, they do not deny. ويقولون بمعنى النصوص كما أراد الله, and they accept the meaning of the text as Allah عز وجل intended. استوى على العرش, he rose over the throne, بمعنى على عليه. This means that Allah عز وجل سبحانه وتعالى rose above it. That is what it means. وليس معناه استولى, and it does not mean that he overcame and overtook. بيده يد حقيقية. When Allah says بيده يد حقيقية, it's a real hand. وليست القوة والنعمة, and it is not the might or favor. فلا تحريف عندهم ولا تعطيل. So there is no distortion and there is no denial with the people of Sunnah and Jama'ah. Now we go into another technical area, and it's interesting. ومن غير تكييف, and without saying how, or let's call it the howness. Let's coin this term, the howness. لم ترد في الكتاب والسنة, لكن ورد ما يدل عن النهي عن على النهي عنها. It did not come, this word takif did not occur in the Quran and the Sunnah, but there are evidences that prohibit it. التكييف هو أن تذكر كيفية الصفة. Let's define it. Takif is that you explain or you mention the howness of the attribute, the manner of the attribute. ولهذا نقول كيف يكيف تكيفا. That's why we say, you know, كيف, he mentioned how, and he mentions how, and howness. أي ذكر الكيفية الصفة, meaning he mentioned the howness of the attribute. He mentioned the howness of the attribute. والتكيف يسأل عنه بكيف. Now the word تكيف, usually it comes when the question is asked how. When the person says how. فإذا قلت مثلا كيف جاء زيد, if you were to say how did زيد come, تقول راكبا, you say he came riding a mount. إذن كيفت مجيئه. So you've mentioned the howness of his arrival. Or in other words, you've described the manner of his arrival. كيف لون السيارة أبيض, فذكرت لون. How or what is the color of the car? How is the color of the car? You say it's white. So you've mentioned the color. أهل السنة والجماعة لا يكيفون صفات الله. The people of Sunnah and Jama'ah, they do not engage in saying how Allah's attribute is or the manner of those attributes. مستندين في ذلك إلى الدليل السمعي والدليل العقلي. And we refer in that to textual evidence first and then the intellectual evidence as well. Rational evidence. أما الدليل السمعي, as for the textual evidence, فمثل قوله تعالى, فمثل قوله تعالى, قل إنما حرم ربي الفواحش ما ظهر منها وما بطن والإثم والبغي بغير الحق وأن تشركوا بالله ما لم ينزل به سلطانا وأن تقولوا على الله ما لا تعلمون. The things that my Lord has indeed forbidden are the fawahish, whether committed openly or secretly, sins, oppression, joining partners with Allah for which He has not given any authority, and saying things about Allah of which you have no knowledge. والشاهد في قوله وأن تقولوا على الله ما لا تعلمون. The evidence that we're trying to focus on, the testimony in this is, and that you say about Allah that which you have no knowledge of. فإذا جاء رجل وقال, if a man were to come and say, إن الله استوى على العرش على هذه الكيفية, if a person would say Allah rose over the throne in this particular manner, Allah rose over the throne in this particular manner, ووصف كيفية معينة, and he mentioned any type of manner, نقول هذا قد قال على الله ما لم يعلم. We say this person has said about Allah that which he does not know. هل أخبرك الله بأنه استوى على هذه الكيفية؟ Did Allah inform you that he rose over the throne in this particular manner? لا, no. أخبرنا الله بأنه استوى. Allah did inform us that he rose. ولم يخبرنا كيف استوى. He did not inform us how he rose. فنقول هذا تكييف وقول على الله بغير علم. So we say this is a form of you doing تكييف, meaning describing the manner, and it falls under speaking about Allah Azza wa Jal with no knowledge. ولهذا قال بعض السلف إذا قال لك الجهمي إن الله ينزل إلى السماء فكيف ينزل؟ فقل إن الله أخبرنا بأنه ينزل ولم يخبرنا كيف ينزل وهذه قاعدة مفيدة. So the Shaykh said, if a person from the followers of Jahm ibn Safwan, if a Jahmi, Jahmites, if he tells you, our Lord descends to the lowest heaven, how does he descend? You say to him, Allah told us that he descends, but he did not tell us how he descended. And that is a beneficial principle. This is a beneficial principle. I mean, what do you want me to do? Do you want me to deny that Allah goes descends? Because Allah said it. Do you want me to describe to you how? Why would I if Allah didn't describe? Do you understand? So you have people that will deny that Allah descended to the lowest heaven because they're like, oh, wait, we cannot describe Allah in this way. Ya akhi, but Allah said it. The Prophet ﷺ said it. And people who want to go technical, how? Explain to me, logically, how does that work? Ya akhi, Allah didn't tell us how. And he told us that there's nothing like unto him. Why are you comparing the creator to the creation to begin with? Why are you trying to understand Allah in the context of humans? Ya akhi, leave it alone, man. You see how beautiful it is to be from Ahl-us-Sunnah wal-Jamaa'ah. Ya Rabbi laka alhamdu hamdan kathiran tayyiban mubarakan fih. Ya Rabbi laka alhamd. Dalilun akhar min as-sam'i. We have another evidence from the textual evidence. Another textual evidence. Qala ta'ala, wa la taqfu ma laysa laka bihi ilm. إن السمع والبصر والفؤاد كل أولئك كان عنه مسؤولا. And don't follow that which you have no knowledge of. Verily the hearing and the sight and the heart, all of these you will be questioned about. لا تتبع ما ليس لك به. Don't go following that which you have no knowledge of. You will be asked about those. وأما الدليل العقلي. As for the intellectual rational evidence. فكيفية الشيء لا تدرك إلا بواحد من ثلاثة. For you to really understand the manner in which something happens, that can only be achieved in one of three ways. مشاهدته, you observe it, you see it. أو مشاهدة نظيره, or you see something similar to it. أو خبر الصادق عن, or you receive sound information about it. أي إما أن تكون شاهدته أنت وعرفت كيفيته. Either you saw it yourself so you know how. أو شاهدت نظيره, or you have seen something similar to that. كما لو قال واحد إن فلان اشترى سيارة داتسون موديل 88 رقم 2000. The Shaykh رحمه الله. He said if a person says so and so bought a Datsun, you know, car model 88 year 2000. لأن فتعرف كيفيته. You know the manner or the howness of the car. لأن عندك مثله, because you have a similar car. أو خبر صادق عن, or the third one is يعني if you receive information, that sound information from a trustworthy person. You receive information from a trustworthy person. Where was I? نعم. أتاك رجل صادق قال إن سيارة فلان صفتها كذا وكذا. A person comes to you and says, look man, this guy's car, its description is such and such and such and such. ووصفها تماما. He gave you perfect description. فتدرك الكيفية. And you will have an idea of the manner and the howness of the car because the guy gave you a very specific description. You know, this kind of bumper, that kind of light, that kind of window, that kind of tire. He gave you some sort of description, so now you have an idea about how it is. وَلِهَذَا أَيْضًا قَالَ بَعْضُ الْعُلَمَاءِ جَوَابًا لَطِيفًا. Some of the scholars gave a very subtle reply. إِنَّ مَعْنَى قَوْلَنَا بِدُونِ تَكِيفٍ لَيْسَ مَعْنَاهَا أَلَّا نَعْتَقِدْ لَهَا كَيْفِيَّةً. If when we say that without speaking about the manner, this does not mean that we do not believe it doesn't have a how. بَلْ نَعْتَقِدُ لَهَا كَيْفِيَةً. We know that there is a manner for it. لَكِنِ الْمَنْفِي عِلْمُنَا بِالْكَيْفِيَةً. We're only denying saying we don't know about it. We're not saying there is no manner. How does Allah descend to the lowest heaven? There's no manner. No, there is a manner. There must be a manner. But do we speak about it? No. Why? Because we don't know. So we're only denying our knowledge of the manner. We're not denying the kayfiyah or the howness in and of itself. لِأَنَّ اسْتِوَاءَ اللَّهِ عَلَى الْعَرْشِ لَا شَكَّ لَنَّ لَهُ كَيْفِيَةً. No doubt that Allah rising over the throne has a manner. لَكِنْ لَا نَعْلَمْ. We don't know what it is. نُزُولُ إِلَى سَمَاءِ الدُّنْيَا لَهُ كَيْفِيَةً. Allah's ascension to the lowest heaven has a manner. لَكِنْ لَا تَعْلَمْ. But you don't know. لِأَنَّهُ مَا مِنْ مَوْجُودٍ إِلَّا وَلَهُ كَيْفِيَةً. There isn't anything that exists except that it has a manner. There's a howness to it. لَكِنَّهَا قَدْ تَكُونُ مَعْلُومَةً وَقَدْ تَكُونُ مَجْهُولَةً. However, it could be known or it also could be unknown. سُئِلَ الْإِمَامُ مَالِكُ سئل الإمام مالك رحمه الله عن قوله تعالى الرحمن على العرش استوى. He was asked about the statement the most gracious rose over the throne. كيف استوى. How did Allah عز وجل rise. فأطرق مالك برأسه حتى علاه العرق. So he bowed his head until He started perspirating and sweating until he was soaked with sweat. ثم رفع رأسه. Then he raised his head. وقال الاستواء غير مجهول. He said, the rising is not unknown. أي من حيث المعنى معلوم. Meaning from a meaning point of view, we know what it means. لأن اللغة العربية بين أيدينا. Because the Arabic language is right here in front of us. It's within our hands. It's known. كل المواضع التي وردت فيها استواء معداتا بعلى معناها العلو. All of the occurrences where the word استواء came preceded by the preposition على, huh? That came with the preposition ala, it means to rise over. معناها العلو. فقال الاستواء غير مجهول والكيف غير معقول. So he said, الاستواء is not unknown, and the how is not something that is intellectually possible. The how is beyond our intellect. لأن العقل لا يدرك الكيف. Your mind can never encompass the how. فإذا انتفى الدليل السمعي والعقلي عن الكيفية وجب الكف عنها. If you don't have any textual evidence nor an intellectual evidence about how, then you have to leave it alone. والإيمان به واجب. Believing in that is obligatory. لأن الله أخبر بي عن نفسه. Because Allah said that about himself. فوجب تصديقه. It is obligatory that you believe Allah سبحانه وتعالى. والسؤال عنه بدعة. And asking about this is an innovation. السؤال عن الكيفية بدعة. To ask the how about any of the attributes of Allah is an innovation. لأن من هم أحرص منا على العلم ما سألوا عنها. Because people that were more keen on knowledge than we are never asked about this. وهم الصحابة. And those were the صحابة. لما قال الله تعالى لما قال الله استوى على العرش. When Allah said استوى على العرش. Allah rose over the throne. عرفوا عظمة الله عز وجل. They knew the greatness of Allah عز وجل. ومعنى الاستواء على العرش. And they knew the meaning of rising over the throne. وأنه لا يمكن أن تسأل كيف استوى. And that it is impossible that you will ever ask how did he rise over the throne. لأنك لن تدرك ذلك. Because you will never be able to encompass it. You will never be able to acquire it. فنحن إذا سئلنا نقول فنقول هذا السؤال بدعة. So if we're asked, we say this is a bid'ah. Why? Because the Sahaba didn't ask it to the Prophet عليه السلام. If they had him and they didn't ask him, then you shouldn't be asking afterwards. وَكَلَامُ مَالِكِ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ وَكَلَامُ مَالِكِ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ مِيزَانٌ لِجَمِيعَ الصِّفَاتِ. the statement of Imam Malik rahimahullah is the scale for all the attributes. فَإِنْ قِيلَ لَكَ مَثَلًا إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَنْزِلُ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ الدُّنْيَا كَيْفَ يَنْزِلُ. If someone says to you, Allah descends to the lowest heaven, how does he descend? فَالنُّزُولُ غَيْرُ مَجْهُولٌ. We say that going, descending is not unknown. وَالْكَيْفُ غَيْرُ مَعْقُولٌ. And how is not achievable. وَالْإِيمَانُ بِهِ وَاجِبٌ. Believing in it is obligatory. وَالسُّؤَالُ عَنْهُ بِدْعَةٌ. And asking about it is an innovation. وَالَّذِينَ يَسْأَلُونَ كَيْفَ يُمْكِنُ النُّزُولُ وَثُلُثُ اللَّيْلِ يَنْتَقِلُ. And the people get more technical. They say, how can there be a descent when the last third of the night varies from one location on earth to another? Right? So they want to be smart. For example, if it's the last third of the night here in Riyadh, it is not the last third of the night in Los Angeles. So then how does that work? فنقول السؤال هذا بدعة. We say this question is an innovation. Allahu Akbar. كيف تسأل عن شيء ما سأل عنه الصحابة. Why are you asking about something that the Sahaba didn't ask about? وهم أحرص منك على الخير. They were better than you and more keen on goodness وعلى العلم, and they were keen on knowledge بما يجب لله عز وجل, regarding everything that is of Allah's right. ولسنا بأعلم من الرسول عليه الصلاة والسلام. And we, the people being asked, are not more knowledgeable than the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم. فهو لم يعلمهم. So Prophet ﷺ did not teach them. فسؤالك هذا بدعة. This question of yours is an innovation. ولولا أن نحسن الظن بك لقلنا ما يليق بك بأنك رجل مبتدع. And had we not assumed good about you, we would have said what is befitting is that you are an innovator. Today, on social media, you have plenty of those people that fall into innovation out of ignorance. And they don't want to be criticized. And they don't want to be mentioned. And they don't want to be corrected. And they want to issue fatawa left and right. And they want to type on their keyboards and give lectures on every subject matter, whether they know it or they, and most of them don't even know Arabic. They don't even know the basic of Arabic. They don't even know anything. But they want to point fingers at others who don't know. Because they're teaching the يعني يا جماعة الخير. Allah المستعان. Allah المستعان. If you only comprehend this, wallahi, you'll be in peace. You'll be in Jannah of the dunya before you go to the Jannah of the akhirah. بإذن الله عز وجل. Wallahi, you'll be in the Jannah of the dunya from a belief point of view. You know exactly what to believe about Allah. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Ni'mah. Wallahi, it's a bounty after which there's no bounty. والإمام مالك رحمه الله قال ما أراك إلا مبتدعا. Actually, Imam Malik said to this man, excuse me, I see you as nothing but an innovator. ثم أمر به فأخرج. Then he commanded that this person will be kicked out of the masjid. لأن السلف يكرهون أهل البدع وكلامهم واعتراضاتهم وتقديراتهم ومجادلاتهم. Because the people of the Salaf, they hate the people of innovation and their speech, and their objections, and their analysis, and their argument. Eh, wallahi, we do. Wallahi, we do until today. Ya akhi, ya Allahu, ya Allah. And then you have the common Joe, who's always on the computer. Brother, why did you not advise him in private? Brother, why are you dividing the ummah, brother? Stop dividing the ummah, brother. Why can't you all speakers come together on one platform and have a big, you know, group hug? Yay! Just me and all the other, all these mashayikh and all these du'at come. Yalla, 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 yalla. Group hug. Yay! Yalla, let the ummah prosper. Where are you living, ya akhi? What utopia are you living in? What world are you living in? Ya'ani, how are you going to deny what Allah promised was going to happen to the ummah and what Prophet ﷺ already prophesied of the division of the ummah and all the calamities? Where are we going to go with that? Where are you going to go with the ummah divided into 73 sects? And they're not going to be on the same page. Wallahi, they will not. We cannot. We want to, but we cannot. So wake up. Understand that on the scene, there are people calling you to Jannah and people calling you to Jahannam. Wallahi al-Azim. The Prophet ﷺ, in the hadith of Ibn Mas'ud, he drew a line, said, this is the straight line of Allah. And then he drew lines on the side. He said, these are other paths. On the top of each is a shaitan calling you to him. Ya jama'a, wallah. This is the speech of the Prophet ﷺ. These are the choice of words of the Prophet. He called them shayateen. Shayateen, they will be calling you to some new version of Islam, modernized, watered down, westernized version of Islam. This is what Prophet ﷺ called them. When someone tries to call you back to the truth, you get mad at him. Yeah, go get mad at those who are changing the religion. You want to give them the benefit of the doubt, but you don't give anyone who calls you to the truth any benefit of the doubt. This is following desires, man. But inshallah, you have good intentions. I say nothing but love for you. May Allah forgive us and forgive you and forgive all the Muslims. Tayyib. We will stop at this point, inshallah, before we continue bi'idhnillah azza wa jal next week with a more beautiful discussion on the matter of takif. And then we go into the tamthil and tashbih and those subject matters which some of you have asked about in the past. Let's see what we have here in terms of questions. I can see questions from YouTube for the first time. I'm being advanced. Watching from Adelaide, Australia. Keep Allah bless you, brother Khalid. Barakallah feek, Habibi. Brother, the book Outwitting the Devil by Napoleon Hill. It's amazing. Wasn't you that recommended it for analyzing? No, brother. I'm not even familiar with this book, Habibi. May Allah forgive me. What do you think about Nasir Muhammad Yemeni, who claims to be the Mahdi?
What do you think I'm going to think? What Mahdi, ya Sheikh? Allah yahdik, ya Sheikh. Ayy Mahdi, ya Baba. Where are the signs of the last day, the minor and the major, before we see a Mahdi? Allah? Watching from the Philippines, ahlan wa sahlan, the Philippines, the land of the free. Is it? I don't know why I said that. Assalamu alaikum from Bangladesh. Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullah. My Bangladeshi brothers who always leave comments in Bengali that I never understand. Jazakumullah khair. Keep it coming. So I believe that Imam Razi came to the correct side of Islam before passing away. You could see from that statement that he was making, he mentioned towards the end that yes, I've tried everything and it was all a fail. Alhamdulillah, just like Al-Imam Al-Ash'ari, Abu Musa, Al-Imam Al-Ash'ari, subhanallah, he's the madhab of Ash'ari is named after him. He repented to Allah before he died. But his followers still follow him on his old belief, the misguided belief, and they refuse the new one. What can you do, ya akhi? What can you do? Allahu Akbar, Kabira, walhamdulillah, kathira. If someone believes Allah is everywhere out of ignorance, that person will be excused, right? Inshallah, but they have to be educated. I mean, yes, excuse is in, if they have misinterpreted some ayat, but I mean, how are you gonna, all the ayat in the Quran that tell you that Allah, you know, is above and He sends down the Quran and He sends down this and the things go up to Him. Yani, but yes, inshallah, if someone is ignorant because of the environment they were brought up in, we hope and pray that they will be excused. Is Nike haram, as it said that it's the goddess of victory? Ya akhi, look, it's a confusing matter. Yes, it is. It is definitely the goddess of victory, but the point of contention is most people don't know that. Most people don't know that. And yani, if you think along those same lines, then you also have the names of the weeks are named after gods and the names of the months are named. There are so many things, so many cars are named after gods. Yani, I've heard multiple opinions about it. You follow whatever you think is more pleasing to Allah. The author argued that we should not ask what the Salaf didn't ask. Can you elaborate on that? Because you might come across many other questions. Yeah, I'm saying if they ask you a technical matter, you say to them, look, you're asking me, right? Yeah. You tell them, are you more keen on learning than the Sahaba? They're going to say no. You're going to say, do you think I'm more knowledgeable than the Prophet ﷺ? They're going to say, no. So you tell them, if people that were more keen on learning had the most knowledgeable person and they never had this conversation, then why are we having it? You get it? It's a beautiful answer. How do you explain Tawheed to a beginner? By telling them that, you know, Tawheed is the oneness and uniqueness of Allah, that Allah is the creator of the heavens and the earth. There's nothing like unto Him. He's the only creator, He's the only sustainer, He's the only provider, He knows everything, He controls everything, He decreed everything, and He created us to worship Him, and He prepared heaven and hell for those who obey and for those who disobey. And you know, you go on from there. Tafsir of al-Zamakhshari, stay away from the Zamakhshari. The tafsir of Ahl-us-Sunnah wal-Jamaa'ah are not that many. I recommend that you stick to al-Tabari, and you'd stick to Tafsir Abdurrahman Nasir Sa'di Rahimahullah and Tafsir Ibn Kathir. Hey, be careful of other Tafasir. Now, you know, Nu'man Khan uses, for example, all of these Tafasir and he brings about all types of calamities in his Tafsir because he refers to everybody, regardless of their Aqeedah. Can you inform me about the meaning of Tawheed al-Ubudiyya? Yeah, Tawheed al-Ubudiyya is basically the same as Tawheed al-Uluhiyya. Uluhiyya is in reference to Allah being the one worthy of worship. Ubudiyya is in reference to the Abd, meaning you are the one who worship Allah alone. You being the Abd versus Allah being the Ilah. So it's basically the concept of you worshiping Allah only and not associating anyone in worship with Him. Bilal Phillips is okay, yes, alhamdulillah. Today, IOU has gone off the track, to be very clear. I know Dr. Bilal personally, I've co-lectured with him. I've spent personal time with him. I learned when I first got into da'wah, it was primarily because of Dr. Bilal Phillips, may Allah protect him. I know nothing but good of him. Of course, nobody's perfect. But I don't agree with where IOU has gone. So Islamic Online University is on some other stuff right now, but the doctor himself, yani, I know nothing but good of him, Allahu A'lam. If you call someone but you did it by mistake, is it shirk? I don't know, I didn't understand the question. My relatives follow many bid'ah, even shirk, like visiting grave. So should I keep relations with them or not? Of course you should keep relations with your relatives and you should call them. When we say that the people of the Salaf hated the people of innovation, doesn't mean you boycott your family. This was back then. Today you have to learn and teach, learn and teach. Bring them about, bring them around. Teach them, educate them. You want them to go to Jannah with you. You want them to go to Jannah with you. If you call someone, but you did it by mistake, is it shirk? What do you mean if you call someone? If you make dua by mistake, is it shirk? Wallahi, Raymond Noodles, I have no idea what you're saying. How are you going to make dua by mistake? Wallah, Habibi, I didn't understand what you're saying. Ma'alesh, ya akhi. And change the name? Tayyib. With this, then we will conclude. May Allah bless you all and reward you with goodness and expand your chests and mine and those of the Muslims to the truth, and may Allah Azza wa Jal accept our good and forgive our shortcomings. هذا والله أعلم وصلى الله وسلم على محمد سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Thanks for watching this video. Subscribe and click on the notification bell. Like, comment, and share with friends and family.